So my dear students, how are you doing? Welcome to our today's lesson. I think that you have been keeping safe at home. So I'll be able want us to continue from where we left yesterday. So for today's lesson, I want us to go direct to where we are going to deal with the possibility diagram. So in this case, we are going to deal with the possibility diagram. These are the diagrams that are going to assist us when we are dealing with the theoretical probability. So they are the ones that are going to guide us on how to come up with the concept of the theoretical probability, because we agree that in the theoretical probability, you don't need to perform an experiment, you don't have to rely on the past experience. What you need to list is the number of the possible outcomes. So you as a learner, the objective of the today's lesson, I want you to be able to derive the set of all possible outcomes. Because you have agreed that in the theoretical probability, for you to be able to find it, it is going to be given by the favorable number of the outcome over the total possible number of the outcome. Therefore, this time we are withdrawing the word trials, which was there in terms of the experiment. So in this case, the content is going to be the same again. So that's going to be our content there. So the content is going to be still on the concept of the theoretical probability. So we're going to emphasize on that idea. And in that case of that idea, we'll be speaking more on it, on the terms of the drawing those possibility diagrams. So that's where the content is going to be. So starting with the introduction, and you can see what you're saying, that the probability space is the set of the all possible number of the outcomes. The way we agreed in the theoretical probability, you cannot be able to perform it if you don't come up with the list of the possible number of the outcome. Then again we say, this list of the possible number of the outcome, what is going to simplify it is by getting all those lists of the outcome by drawing a possibility diagram to show the outcomes clearly. So if you need to come up with a list of the all possible outcome, it will be very easy if you draw the diagram. So how are these diagrams drawn? So you are saying that the possibility diagram can be in the form of either a table, not a table, it can be again in the form of a tree diagram. So those are the two things. So today I want us to focus on the table, then when I'll be teaching about the independent event and the combined event, then that is the time that I will focus on the issue of the tree diagram. So we focus today on the case of the table. So I'm going to be giving you some examples, and those examples are the one that you're going to narrow down with them, then they are going to guide us on how we come up with the table, then that table, how does it assist us to come with the list of all possible number of the outcomes. So that is now my example number one, and you can see that in the example number one we are saying that you have the two dice. One is red in color, then the other one is blue in color. Then they are drawn up, they are drawn at the same time, and then the numbers showing on each dice are added together. Then you are told to find the probability of what is going. I'll find the probability that one, the sum is 7, then the sum is less than 5. So, how many possible outcomes are you going to have when you draw the two dice together at once? So meaning, those outcomes, for you to be able to see them, you need to be able to draw a table that is going to see, that's going to tell you the number of the possible outcomes. So here we go, that is number one. We are told that the first one is red, so you can say the red to remain horizontally there, and then the blue one to be vertical. Because remember, you are drawing them at once. Then we know that when you are drawing the when you are drawing up the die, the least possible of number of the outcome, there are 6 of them. So now this is 1. Then you can get a 2, you can get a 3, a 4, a 5, and then a 6. Those are the least possible number of the outcome that you can have. Then the same case again comes to here. We have a 1 there. Then we have a 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is going to be the shielded there. And then from there we have the possible number of the outcomes that they're going to have. This is the one we are calling the form of a table. Going to assist you. ama vile possibility yangu. Whatever it is on. Don't use free hands when you're drawing it, make sure you have a brother. You only have these are not the six. Then here you're going to have these. So that's the theme of that meter that we're going to use. So in this case, we are told that they are drawn at the same time, and then the numbers showing on the dice are added together. They are going to be added together. So when you carry out addition, we are going to see this way, 1 plus 1, is going to be 1 plus 1, then you get is 2. Okay? Then from there we have 2 plus 4. Then from there we have this one, we are starting with the horizontal, we add to the vertical. So we have, this is 1 plus 1, get 2. Then we have 2 plus 1. Get our 3 there. That's the meter that I want us to follow. Then we have 3 plus 1, get that is 4. Then we have 4 plus 1, get that is 5. Then from there we have 5 plus 1, 6. Then 6 plus 1, we get is 7. So the same case again, is going to repeat itself again here. We have 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, get 1 plus 2, get 3. 2 plus 2, 4. Then here is 5. 6, then that is 7, then that is 8. Then here again you have 1 plus 3, that is 4. That's the case there. Then from there 2 plus 3, 5. Then 3 plus 3, 6. And again 4 plus 3 is half 7. Then 5 plus 3 half 8. Then 9. So again here we have the 1 plus 4, 5, 6. Then 3 plus 4 you get 7. Then 4 plus 4 you get is 8. Then 5 plus 4 you get is 9. Then 6 plus 4 you get is 10. So my case again to this one, we have 1 plus 5, you get that is 6. Then 7. Then you have 8. Then you have this one is 9. Then you have 5 plus 5 is 10. And then you have 11. Same again, 1 plus 6, 7. Then there we have 8, then we have 9, 10, 11, 12. That's how we fill the table. So you can see that the table is assisting us to be able to come up with a list of all possible number of the outcomes which you are going to have. So from this table, you can be able to see how many outcomes you're going to have. So these ones, don't confuse them, you can shape them. So these are the outcomes for the die. Remember, don't confuse them again. That is the diagram of blue. So your outcome are going to be these ones which are there in six. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Play the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So all the list of all possible outcomes are going to be 36 outcomes in total. 36 outcomes. As we are saying, that the table is assisting you to be able to come up with a list of all possible number of the outcomes. So with now this table, you can be able to answer your question very clearly, because it's just only now having to be able to focus on what the examiner is requiring you to do. So question number A, we are told that the sum is 7. So what is the probability of getting that the sum is 7? So if you want to see how many 7s are there, which one are giving us that the 7 there? So you can be able to count them. There are how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They're going to be 6 of them are favoring 7 over the total number of outcome which you have seen there, 36. It is going to be 6 divided by 36. And when you divide that one, you get by 6, 1, then by 6, 6. So the probability of you getting the 7 is 1.6. So you get your 1 mark. Remember we said the answer that you're going to be giving, it should be on a simplified form. So don't give the answer 6 over 36, but you need to simplify it and then you get your answer is 1 over 6. Then number 2, you are told that the sum is less than 5. So when you come to the case when you are told that the sum is less than 5, what does that one mean? So the probability of the sum that is supposed to be less than 5. So this means that 5 is not included. Less than 5. So make sure that if it is less than 5, you don't include the five. So you're going to go from four and below. And if you count them, you're going to see how many are going to be. So you don't include five, so it's going to be how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's only the trick there to be able to identify. Do you know the meaning of the word less than five? For some of you, if you include five, then that one is going to be the mistake. So there are six of them again, then this one is going to be, then that is six. The probability of getting less than five is going to be six. And then over the total, it is 36. Then by 6, 1, by 6, 6. So the answer becomes 1 over 6. Again, you get your answer 1. So identifying that the 5 is not included, you get your method 1. Then getting the correct answer, you get your answer is going to be 1 over 6. So in my next again, you can see what you are told, that the sum is greater than or equal to 8. The sum should be probability of getting that you get the sum is greater than or equal to 8. Greater than or equal to 8. So this one meaning 8 is included. That is one mark. 8 is going to be included. That is another trick that you're supposed to do to know to identify. That's why you're given the mark. So you're going to include the 8, the probability that the sum is going to be greater or equal to 8. So from 8 you count them. So you're going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So this one is going to give us 15. 15 over 36. Then this one you're going to say, if you simplify, this one is going to be what? 15 over 36. And if we simplify it, I think that is going to be only the answer. Okay, by 3. By 3, 5. Then by 3, 12. So your answer is going to be 5 over. So that's how you're going to get that one. You're getting your 3 marks there. So the other part you're going to meet in my next part of the video. I am out.